Hey, this is Mike. Thank you so much for choosing this video. Today I'm in Whiteville, North Carolina, visiting Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram, and I'm checking out a 2017 Jeep Cherokee Latitude. Now this is a four-wheel drive vehicle, and it has the towing package and a V6 and a lot of other cool features to show off. So let's go ahead and check it out. Now this vehicle has 17-inch alloy wheels, painted silver, which gives you a nice contrast with the granite paint. And it has four-wheel disc brakes with ventilated disc brakes in the front and solid disc brakes in the back. The name of this color is Granite Crystal Metallic Clear Coat. And it's a really, really good dark color as an alternative to black, because you don't have to wash it as much, basically. So let's check out the front end. Now the front end has the 7-slot grille with the chrome accents around it, which is looking good with the granite. You have accent lighting here at the top. Now these top lights are not your headlights. Those are your daytime running LEDs. Your actual headlights are there more towards the center, and they're bi-xenon HID high and low beam projector headlights, and they look really nice at nighttime. And then you have halogen reflector fog lights at the bottom. So this is what the key looks like. It's a proximity design key. It's designed to actually keep it in your pocket the whole time. You don't even have to take it out. But if you do, you have some buttons here, the lock and unlock buttons, the power lift gate, and a remote start. You also have a panic button. Let's go ahead and push that and see what happens. It just beeps the horn, flashes the lights, and it has a pretty loud horn for a smaller vehicle. To remote start the vehicle, you just double tap here, and it'll beep twice if you have that setting on, and it'll start up. Now it'll run for 15 minutes, and you can actually do that 3 times before it will just not do anything, so it doesn't, like say if your child or something is playing around with the remote, they can't sit there and remote start it all day long. Okay, to turn it off, you just double tap it again, it'll turn right back off. So with the key in your pocket, you can walk up to the vehicle. Right now it's locked. So if I grab right here and pull out, it's completely locked so I can't get in. Now if I want to unlock it, I just put my hand behind the handle. It senses the key close to the vehicle. It senses my hand position and it unlocks the door. If I want to relock it, I just push this button here and it relocks the vehicle. So I can use the vehicle without even having the key out. Here's the inside of the passenger door. Now you have soft to the touch features here around your arm. You have some stitching and a wood grain surface there accenting the sides. You have automatic one touch up and down windows here in the front, power windows. You have a nice big bottle holder and a little place to put some stuff. Here's your threshold. You have manually adjusted seats here on the passenger side, but it does have the up and down adjustment. Cloth black seats with the accent stitching and a little bit of a pattern there in the center. Now this particular one has the storage in the seat. So underneath the seat you have the storage compartment, and this is a good spot to hide your valuables, so it keeps it out of sight. And it's pretty good size. You can actually put like a small bag or something in there, and you know, it keeps it out of the way and keeps it in a kind of hidden spot. Okay, so you also have a lockable glove compartment, and this has one of the biggest glove compartments I've ever seen. It goes way back in there. I mean, you can put like a whole clipboard and books, your school books, whatever you want in this glove compartment. It's absolutely amazing. So this one has privacy glass, the tinted glass here in the back, and it's not a film or anything. It's actually glass is tinted itself. So you can see it keeps the sun from shining in and people from looking in so much. But looking from the inside out, you can see quite well. So that's good. It reduces your glare, actually, so it makes you see better. Okay, so here's the inside of the back door. You have the same contrast stitching and the soft-to-the-touch surfaces around your arm. You even have the wood grain there and the bottle holder. Okay, so I have the seat all the way up and the front seat all the way back, just to kind of give you an idea of the adjustability here. So this is a 60-40 split seat system, not only in the back of the seat, but also in the bottom. So you can actually move the seat forward and back, depending on your cargo needs or whatever. Of course, you can see there's no leg room in this position, but it gives you some added cargo space when you need it. So let's go ahead and move this back so you can get an idea of the difference there. So this front seat's all the way back, keep that in mind. But look at the floorboard. The floorboard goes in all the way, pretty good way, so that way it feels like you're in a chair back here. You don't feel like you're kind of scrunched up. Your knees are not going to be sticking up in the air, even if you're quite tall. You do have a small, very small actually, for a four-wheel drive vehicle, a hump there in the center. So that way you don't have to really straddle it too much. You have some cup holders and a armrest here in the center when you don't have a center passenger. You even have a power supply down there. Now this is the AC adapter, so that way you can plug in a laptop or charge your cell phone if you need to. And then your AC vents are here. So you're able to fold the seats down to get some more cargo space in a 60-40 split fashion. There's a little strap right here. Just pull that. It folds the seat down. Now you will have to move this front seat up slightly just so it give it room to fold down. And you can have a combination of cargo and passenger space, depending on your needs, by folding one or both, one or the other or both. The fuel door is lockable. There's the button for it. And it's on the passenger side. And it has the cap there with a little tether and a little place to hang it as well to keep it away from your nice granite paint and out of the way. Okay, let's take a look at the back of the vehicle. Now this one has the cargo racks, roof racks there at the top. It also has the backup camera in the perfectly center position here. You also have the trailer tow group, which comes with a 4- and 7-way outlet for your trailer, as well as a class 3 trailer hitch. And it also has heavy duty engine cooling. And with the V6, you have the dual exhaust tips back here, which is looking pretty nice. It also has trailer sway damping, I should say. So if the trailer starts swaying, if you ever seen a trailer on the road, it starts to move sideways back and forth. Well, if that happens in this vehicle, it will help mitigate that until you can solve the problem by alternating the back brakes back and forth to keep that trailer from swaying back and forth, which is a good safety feature. You also have LED taillights, combination of LED and standard taillights back here. Okay, so opening up the vehicle in the back, you can, of course, push a button under here. Right under here is a button to open up the power liftgate, but I'm going to use the key this time. So on the key, you just double tap that, and it will go ahead and open up for you. That's really handy, having the remote start and then being able to open this up. So you're leaving the store, you're headed to the vehicle, and this key works like a football field away, easy. So you can go ahead and remote start your vehicle, get the air conditioning or the heat going, and open up your power lift gate as you're walking up to the vehicle, and it just kind of gets everything going when you get to the vehicle. Okay, so here's your cargo area. Now if you have the backseat passengers, y'all still have a massive amount of cargo space in this vehicle. So you can see it has this little bar here, which you can actually attach things to that bar. There's different accessories that Jeep offers that attaches to that. You can also take it out like so. It unhinges. And it's also useful for, like, say if you're going to stand up. In my case, I would use like a tripod, standing up in this little bin here to stand up there, and then I can use this bar to kind of secure it, keep it from falling down. So I thought that was pretty cool. You also have a 12-volt power supply down here, and you can see it has the key on it, so it's letting you know that it will turn on and off with the ignition. You have two light sources back here, here and here. That really helps out at night to avoid shadows. There's some grocery bag hangers here on the side. You can also put a cargo net if you want to in place. Right in here is a little door where you can access the manually pull and open up the fuel door if you need to. There's a little storage pocket there. Now there's even more cargo space, but underneath this floor, but I want to show you before I get into that. It has these cargo tie downs here, here, and here, but right on the back of the seat is your car seat anchor. anchor points here and here and here. You don't want to get those confused. So when you're hooking up your car seat, you definitely want to use the anchors and not the cargo hook here. So you don't want to use that for your car seat. Okay, so more cargo space under here. Now it is shared with your spare tire. Now this is a full-size spare tire. This comes with the trailer tow group. So that way when you're pulling a trailer, you don't want to have those little tiny donut tires. You got to have a full-size tire. So you can, of course, utilize some space around the tire for some cargo and, you know, stuff like that. But isn't that nice to have a nice, big, full-size tire on a vehicle like this? Lower the lift gate, you can of course just grab it and pull it down, or you can use the key to push the button, or you can just push this button right here on the side, right here. You push that, step back, it's kind of going to beep at you, let you know it's coming down, and it's coming down. Now if something were to get in the way, like my hand, just a little tiny bit of pressure, it goes right back up. So it's not going to crush anything. Now it will, once it goes down to the bottom, let me show you. When it goes down really close to the bottom, it kind of goes a little bit faster. So you still have to watch out for a little, you know, a child's fingers or something like that. But it is a pretty safe power lift gate when it comes down. Now, if you remote start the vehicle, you still have to get inside the vehicle with the key and push this button before you can go anywhere. Now, to start the vehicle without the remote start, you still have to have the key inside. Put your foot on the brake and push this button. Okay, so here's the floorboard in front of the driver's seat. You can see the floor mat actually hooks in, so it keeps it from sliding around on you. Is your accelerator and brake pedals, and a place to put your foot here on the left. That's a plus for me when driving long distances, to have a nice footrest. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look underneath the hood. Opening the hood is really easy. So right here where this P is, you just follow that straight down in this groove, and there's a little latch that you pull towards you. So you pull towards you, and it lifts up, goes the rest of the way up by itself. So you can see right there is the little lever. Okay, so underneath this cover, big plastic cover, is a six-cylinder, 3.2-liter six-cylinder engine with variable valve timing. And it's paired to a 9-speed automatic transmission. That's right, 9 speeds. So it really has a lot of gear ratios to choose from when you're driving. Now, can't really see too much because of this cover. Actually, let's go ahead and get rid of this cover for a second and check it out. You got a little bit more plastic under there, but you're gonna see a little bit more of the engine. So that intake manifold there is actually plastic, but it is part of the engine. So we get to see some engine. And then here is your battery, which is insulated. And there's your actual oil filter right here. Isn't that neat, easy to get to? Okay, so here's the inside of the driver's door. Now it's just like the other side, except for it has a few more buttons. You have the lock and unlock buttons, the power windows for all four windows, and then you have your adjustable side mirrors. You just pick a side and adjust it with that little pad. Now let's take a look at how fast the windows roll up and down with the automatic feature. It's one touch down, one touch up. Here's your threshold. Then you have a power seat here for the driver, and you have four-way adjustable lumbar support. So this is a very comfortable seat, actually. Let's go ahead and make sure it's all the way back so you can see all the possible legroom here. So some really tall people have been in this vehicle and say it's extremely comfortable for its size, especially. So right in here, you have your headlight controls. You have off, parking light, headlight, and then you have an automatic. To turn your fog lights on, you just push this button there. There's your dimmer switches for your interior gauges here on this side, and then right here is for your ambient lighting. There's a button to open up your power liftgate as well. And then down here, you have this little storage bin for change or whatever you want to use it for. The steering column is a tilt and a telescoping steering column, and you can lock it in place with this little lever there. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look here on the inside. Seats are very comfortable. I have the lumbar support adjusted and the seat right where I want it. Plenty of leg room and knee room. So let's go ahead and take a look at the window sticker before we go too much further. So you can use the pause button to get the information off of it in case you need it. You see the optional equipment there. Now, if you're not familiar with the way these window stickers are formatted, you have your base price, and then you have what the vehicle is, the engine, and stuff like that up here. Then you have the standard equipment listed out, exterior, interior, and then over here you have the optional equipment. And then you'll see the pricing for each option. And from the price to the next price, everything pretty much in between is part of that package. So you can see there's a package, there's a little package, there's a little package, there's a little package. And then it totals up there at the bottom. You can actually see who the original dealer that received it. Sometimes vehicles get bounced around at different dealers, so you can see if it actually went straight to the dealer you're buying it from or another dealer. And then you have your fuel economy there, and then your crash ratings and stuff like that. Okay, let's actually look at the vehicle itself. Let's look at the steering wheel first. So it has a leather wrapped steering wheel. Really good thickness and high quality feeling. The thickness really makes a big deal with your hands when you're driving for long periods of time. If it's too skinny of a steering wheel, it kind of digs into your bones and your hands or whatever, especially if you're kind of over gripping the steering wheel, which this one, you know, it's very, it has a good thickness, and you just kind of, I don't know how to explain it. There's not a real big texture on the leather, but it does grip your hand really well. So let's take a look at the buttons on the steering wheel. Your cruise control is here on the right. You just turn it on with the center button. You can set it to set your speed with either one of those. You can change your speed faster or slower. You can resume, and then you can cancel there. If you push that, it's going to turn it off, so you have to turn it back on before you use it again. On the back of the steering wheel, right back here, I don't know if you can see that, it actually has this toggle switch up and down with a center button here. And that's on both sides of the steering wheel. So as you're driving with your hand on your steering wheel, you use your back fingers to use that control. That's your volume for your radio, the up and down, and then the center button will cycle through the AM, FM, satellite radio, things like that, your different audio sources. On the back side of the steering wheel on this side, you have up and down and center button as well. The up and down cycles through your stations. So like say you can go to the next station, I can go up and it goes up to the next station. The center button will cycle through your presets. So you see your presets, your favorites there at the top. We'll go into the screen a little bit more detail, but that's the buttons there on the back of the steering wheel. Super handy, especially in conjunction with this buttons on the front. So here's your Bluetooth controls. You have your answer calls, hang up, and then your voice recognition. There's a whole bunch of voice commands you can use for this vehicle. In addition to just calling people, so you can say, call Van Underwood. So if you push that button, if Van Underwood is in your phone book on your phone, you can push that, say call Van Underwood, and it'll go ahead and call him. It also, you can say commands like tune to a certain station. Let's just go ahead and push it so you can kind of see what I'm talking about. It's gonna pop up here. Different options. You can set the temperature, you can tune to stations, change source, all that good stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and it recognizes that I said phone, so let's go ahead and just get out of that. But But the voice commands are really good for keeping your hands on the wheel, eyes on the road, and staying productive. You can do what you want to do without fumbling around, looking around inside the vehicle while you're driving 80 miles an hour on the highway. Okay, so these buttons here correspond with this screen between the gauges, which we'll get to in just a minute. Your windshield wiper controls are controlled here on the right side. And then your turn signal switch is there. Okay, so check out the gauges. They have like a kind of a simple design, but just really classy looking. On the left side, you have your RPMs, and it has like a kind of a yellowish gold accented with the white lettering and the black background. And then you have the orange needle popping out there, looking good. And then they're kind of like watch dials in the way, I guess. And on the right side, your speedometer. But right there in the center, you have a digital speedometer. You also have your engine coolant temperature, and on the right side is your fuel gauge, which this vehicle is going to the gas station in a few minutes, so you can see it needs to get some gas. Then you have your outside temperature there, and then you have your digital compass showing that the vehicle is facing west, and then your odometer at the bottom. But basically, this screen has a lot more information. So using these buttons here, the OK and then the arrow buttons, you can cycle through. So I'm going to push the down button so you can see that this is part of a menu system. Speedometer is your first option. Next is your vehicle info. Okay, so, but when you go down to vehicle info, you notice these little dots here at the top showing you that there's more stuff to the right and left. So you can actually get more information about your vehicle depending on what you want to see. Starts off with your tire pressure. All right, scrolling down again is your fuel economy. So you have an average, you have a real time there, and then a current miles per gallon as you drive. Scroll down again, you have two trips, trip A, trip B. Measures your distance, your average fuel economy, and your time. And start, stop, this is where you can actually turn that feature off. But this vehicle has a feature to where you're driving, and when you're stopped at a stoplight or a stop sign for more than a few seconds, it's going to go ahead and turn the engine off. And then as soon as you let go of the brake, it's going to turn the engine right back on instantaneously. It's pretty neat. But that's the status of it right there. Scrolling down, this is what your radio is doing. And then any stored messages will show up here. And your screen setup. This is where you can change, like say if you want to take the digital compass out and put the, let's go ahead and do that. So let's go upper right. We're going to change that to the, we'll go range to empty. That's what I would do. And right now it's just saying low because it's low on fuel. But it'll give you a an actual number there, how many miles you can drive before you get gas. And then scrolling down again, it gives you back to your speedometer. So that's number one. And that would be my default screen, I think. We already saw the start button there. Okay, let's take a look at the center stack. Start at the very top with this compartment. So it has this compartment up here so you can put your sunglasses or whatever in there. Now you do have to make sure you don't put anything that's gonna affect by temperature because it gets hot on the dash. And check out this contrast stitching here. And the dashboard is made out of like this Nerf feeling material, so it's very soft. It's pretty neat. And it's textured, it doesn't reflect any light in your face, so I really like the dashboard. Okay, the center, the screen here is 8.4 Uconnect with the all kinds of cool features. So right now, it has, we're in the radio screen. Now you see it has these little icons here across the bottom. This stays there. So this is your kind of quick access stuff. You do have a little bit of control based on what's down there in the 17 model. So let's go ahead and look at the radio, AM, FM, satellite radio. You have your presets there at the top. You can tune to a specific, you know how satellite radio is, there's lots of stations. You can tune to a direct one there. You can also change your audio source, your audio settings here. So your balance and fade, your equalizer, your speed adjusted volume to where it gets louder as you drive faster. And then you can offset your auxiliary input volume. And then you have the autoplay with the Bluetooth device. So when once it automatically detect something, it's just going to go ahead and start play. You can turn that feature on or off. Next is your media, because there's lots of different ways of playing music through the sound system besides just your radio. You have USB, two USB ports, an auxiliary input, and Bluetooth wireless through the device, and also an SD card input, which I'll show you where all that stuff is in just a minute. And then controls, this is where you would find your you have an auto dim rear view mirror. You can turn that feature on and off. And then you have a ton of settings here that you can go into: display settings, voice settings, adjust your clock, safety settings, brakes, lights. So basically, if you wanted to pair a phone, of course you can go in there. Say if you want to make it to where it doesn't beep the horn when you lock the car or remote start it, so you don't wake up the neighbors early in the morning or something like that, you can go in there and do that in your settings. So let's go to the apps. So the app screen is where you'll find all the different icons. See, some of them are redundant because you have the controls in and controls there. You have iHeartRadio, AHA, and your media sources. There's a lot of additional, just the same ones. But you'll notice this says screen off, and that's a screen off button down here. So let's say I want to take the settings and put it down there. I just grab it and I drag it down kind of slowly. Now the screen's new, so there we go, it puts it there. So that way you can put whatever you want in that position. So that way, you know, you're not stuck with just what they give you. You can choose what you want here. All right, so the next one is your climate control. So you can have your fan speed, temperature for your driver and passenger, where you want the air to blow, recirculate the air, and your front and rear defrosters is all controlled here. You can sync them or have them separate if you want. There's also some redundant buttons down here, which we'll get to in just a minute. We already saw the settings, which there's tons of, there was just an infinite amount of settings here, so I'm not going to go into too much information, but you get the idea. And then the last but not least is your phone screen. Once you pair your phone, you'll have access to your phone book, recent calls. You'll be able to dial, have a little dial pad there. You can always transfer it back to your cell phone just in case you want to have a private call. You don't want everybody in the car to hear your call, so you can transfer it back if you need to. And you can pair up to 6 phones, but they will work only one at a time using a priority system. So, you know, you can pair more than one phone. Okay, so that's kind of a quick rundown of the Uconnect screen here. There's your four-way flashers. Okay, so down here is your traditional volume for your radio and tune through the stations. I keep that screen off button. Your traction control, you can turn that off. You can turn the stop start feature on and off. And then you have a back button for certain screens. You can go back out of those screens by pushing that back button. You have your fan speed, your temperature, and then your recirculate the air and your air conditioner and your front rear defrosters. These are your redundant climate control buttons, which makes it handy to just kind of quickly adjust something on the fly without actually going into a particular screen. Okay, so right in here is your SD card, USB and auxiliary inputs, as well as a 12-volt power supply and a little storage pocket here. So you can put your cell phone or whatever in there and plug it in and charge it, or an iPod or whatever. Okay, so here's your four-wheel drive control. So right now it's an automatic. Now you can put it in, you can turn this dial, and you can put it in snow, it takes a second, sport, sand, or mud. So you're basically telling the vehicle that you need a little bit of help in these particular situations. Automatic should be fine in most cases, but you know, these other ones are just kind of, like say the snow, if it's real slippery, it might start out in a second gear instead of first gear, just to kind of give you an easier start so you don't start spinning wheels, that kind of thing. Okay, so here's your shifter, and it's an electronically controlled shifter, but it's pretty traditional. There's reverse. You can check out the backup camera here. Now it does have the active grid line, so as I turn the steering wheel, it's going to angle them, showing me which way I'm going. And also they're color coded, so you have red and yellow and green showing you the distance. It does have a little bit of a wide angle view, so it's a little bit of distortion on the ends, but this gives you a better view, and the clarity is really good too. So you can see the shadow of the vehicle right there. So you can actually see really close. This is really handy for backing up to a trailer or something like that too. Okay, continuing on, there's reverse. All right, let's go to neutral. There's drive. Now this is your normal drive position. It's going to cycle through all 9 gears automatically for you. But if you want to change through the gears manually, you can bump it over here. And it's not going to like be a sport manual mode, like, you know, you shift through the gears and up and down or whatever. This just tells you your highest gear that you want the vehicle to go in. So when you put it in here, you can adjust your top gear. So this is handy for downshifting when you're going down hills. So if you're going down a hill, especially with a trailer, you want to use some engine braking. You don't always ride the brakes. It might overheat them, and then you'll lose your brakes. So using the engine braking, you can actually lower the gear ratio as you're going down a hill just to use that engine braking feature. Okay, so here's your parking brake, and check it out. It says pull on, kind of cluing you in which way to turn it. So pull it up, and it engages your electronic parking brake. Push it down to disengage it. Now, if you try to move the vehicle while the door is open, so let's go ahead and open the door so you can see what I'm talking about. And then I'm gonna put it in reverse. And then we're gonna kind of move and see what happens. Okay, see, it just stopped the vehicle. Okay, so just in case you actually get out with the vehicle still in gear, and it's gonna stop the vehicle anyway. So you can, the Mythbusters actually demonstrate it, which is pretty neat, on another vehicle. So let's go ahead and turn that feature, that off. Now, you can turn that feature off if you're, for whatever reason, have to move the car a lot with the door open. You can turn that feature off in the settings, but you know, default is on. Okay, so here's your cup holders, and they have the illumination around the outside, and they look really cool at night, kind of like a Tron movie or something. Little storage pocket there to put a pen or whatever. The key fits good there. Okay, so here's your center armrest, and it's wide enough, it looks like, to share with your passenger, and it's pretty soft as well. Has the stitching there, and this lifts up in two portions. So let's go ahead and open up the top portion, and this has this little storage bin here, and it has two, count them, there's one there, and then there's a second one down here, so you know which bin you're opening. So the larger one at the bottom opens up a larger bin right here, and there you can see it has the 12-volt power supply and a USB port. Now that 12-volt power supply has a battery on it, showing you that it actually will stay on with the battery, so you don't have to have the vehicle on to use that power supply. So you can charge your cell phone while you're going in the store or whatever. You also have some places to put wires in and out of the compartment so they don't pinch them when you close the lid. Okay, so here's your rear view mirror. Now it's an auto dim rear view mirror, like I said, and it has a light sensor here on the back, so the shade's covering it up, so it's actually auto dimming right now. And you can see it has some buttons here. This is your roadside assistance and 911. This vehicle actually has its own cellular connection, so even if you don't have your cell phone with you, if it's not paired, if for whatever reason you need emergency assistance or roadside assistance, you can push that button. Now this button here, you can also call in case you want to learn how to adjust something on the radio. So it's actually going to go to a product specialist, which is really cool. And they'll direct you in the right direction there. Okay, so up here, you have a place to put your shades. And has like this rubber liner, and it's pretty good size. So it looks like you can put your Hollywood shades or whatever in there. Then you have some tap lights in case you need a quick reading light. Your visor has a mirror with lights in it as well. It also has your HomeLink garage door opener control right up in here. Same thing on the other side. Okay, so let's take a look at the visibility in the back. Not too bad. I mean, you've got a nice big window back there. The headrests don't really get in the way much. You also have the windows all the way in the back on the sides, as well as the back windows. So the visibility is great. Of course, course, you have the backup camera and stuff like that to help you out as well. Okay, so there you have it. 2017 Jeep Cherokee in the Latitude trim level, four-wheel drive. Lots of cool stuff. Take a look at the window sticker here again. But yeah, it has a lot of optional equipment on here. The four-wheel drive, the select train, four-wheel drive type system. And it's the Jeep Active Drive 1. Because you want to differentiate that. There's Active Drive 1, there's a Active Drive 2, and then there's, I can't remember the third one, but anyways, this one has the Active Drive 1. Okay, so thank you for watching. Thank you to Van Underwood Chrysler Jeep Dodge Ram here in Whiteville, North Carolina, for allowing me to show off an awesome vehicle, and I'll see you guys next time.